Like, comment, share, and subscribe. Hit that notification bell in the upper right-hand corner. Follow me on all forms of social media. Check me out at thegermanguy.com. And enjoy the following presentation.
I really do appreciate you taking this time to be able to talk to me about everything that you got going on right now, and including some a brand new live release from Fates Warning, live over Europe. I've gotten the chance to be able to check this out over the last couple weeks, and it's just awesome to see how tight and amazing Fates Warning is right now.
Thank you. We strive to be perfect. Do our best, for sure. So, and you know, I'm sure playing the same songs for 30 years has kind of helped out a bit.
So, with that, what went into the decision to make a new live Fates Warning album?
It was Jim's idea, actually. Just he kind of brought it up, and like after the last few 4 or 5, 6 years of the last two albums and touring and everything, everyone's gonna kind of take a break right now and do their own thing for a little while, and in the interim, it'd be nice to have a live album for people to hold them over until we figure out what we're doing. And as well as, you know, we have a lot of material. We haven't done a new album in almost 9 years. We did Darkness in a Different Light, and we have a lot of new material that we thought would be interesting to put on the live album, since it's been over 20 years since we've done a live album. So it was just a nice idea. It was fun. You know, we got a little tour out of it, and played a few of our favorite places, and saw some fans, and everyone was, it was really a lot of fun. It was, it was a something to give back to the people, in a way.
Oh, very much so. And I love the song selections that went into it as well. I mean, obviously choosing from different shows, but being able to showcase so much of what I love about Fates Warning in one compilation.
It was like, again, so much music, and we had to pick and choose, like, basically do songs that weren't on the other live album, because no one wants to buy the same thing again twice, but we had to, of course, pick a couple here and there. But it was this is the reason why we played for 2 hours every night, and then in Athens we actually played almost 2 hours and 40 minutes or something. We played the entire set, everything you hear on that album we did that night in Athens. So that was one of the longest, it was the longest show we've ever played. So again, it was fun, and it was grueling, but it was worth the effort, I think. 2 hour shows a night, it was like five in a row, day off, five in a row. So it was a lot of work, but fun.
Oh yeah. And with that, I mean, how much fun is it for you to be able to span that much of the Fates Warning catalog? I mean, with such an incredible album as Theories of Flight, being able to tour and doing live support with that, and of course going back into the classic albums from the 90s with Fates Warning.
Oh, it's a blast, man, it's a little difficult for everybody to have to sit down and relearn some songs, here and there, and like doing Sonic Cries, for instance, my voice doesn't work that way anymore, but in rehearsal, it's kind of, all right, let's give it a shot, and I tried it here at my studio, and it worked out okay, and honestly, now, I actually like the song more now, the way it came out, than it did on the original, to be honest with you. I mean, so things like that, it's a lot of fun, sort of a, what's the word I'm looking for? I just had it in my head. I can't remember things anymore. I'm getting old. But, it was a happy accident. Damn it, what is that word? It's driving me crazy now. Serendipity.
Oh, yes.
There you go. So, and things like that, but again, playing live to me is the best part of being in a band, I think. Being in the studio is one thing, creating and writing it's fun and it's exciting, but I think being on the road is probably the best part of being in a band. You're with your friends the whole time, you're playing in front of your fans, and just playing live to me is just the epitome of being in a group, I think, personally.
Yeah, and as a longtime fan of the band, it's just, again, that's what I appreciate so much about this release. Like, in particular, when you mentioned Silent Cries, like, I have to agree with you. I absolutely love the way that it sounds right now. I mean, with your vocal approach, too, it's with the way the rest of the song has turned out since then. And, you know, it's funny that you can take a song that has been around for such a long time and, you know, just over time, it just changes just enough to become its own thing.
Yeah, it's crazy. Heavy now, I think, than it was the original, which is really weird, but, you know, and Jens did a great job. Jens Borgen did a great job in the mix, I think. I think he captured the live sound perfectly. I mean, that's what I picture We Sound Like from the front. I don't really know, because I'm never really out. Like, if We Sound That Good live, it was something great. I hope so. But, you know, he did a really great job, and I didn't hear any of the mixes, really, until it was almost finished. It was pretty much 90% done, so I was really happy. He's a great, great sound guy, good mixer. He was a producer, engineer, awesome guy. Glad we used him.
Oh, yeah, I couldn't agree more. I mean, to get someone to really capture that live Fates Warning sound, I'm glad you went with him to be able to get that proper mix.
Yeah, yeah, and again, with direction from Jim, because Jim was the one dealing with him directly, so... And great thing, because Jens knows who we are. He's known us for a long time, and not personally, but he's known of our band, and he was happy to work with us. So, again, we're really lucky to have found him. Hopefully we can work with him again. I hope so.
Oh, absolutely. And, of course, with that touring that was going on, I mean, you guys were doing some live promotion for easily what I think might be my favorite Fates Warning album to date, Theories of Flight. What was it like to be able to tour behind such an album like that?
It was a blast, man, to be honest with you. I mean, there was a lot of work writing the album, and Jim and I worked on that thing for almost a year, putting it together. And, you know, it's hard to just take a step back and really appreciate something like that, you know, because you're so used to hearing it day after day after day after day. So when the very first tour, we came out and actually played the songs live, because when we record an album and write, we don't play together. You know, we're doing this through the mail, through the internet. We're sending files back and forth, and gradually the song comes together. But the first time we actually played live and started playing the music was just, the smiles on everyone's faces was enough. You know, it's like, it was challenging enough to do in the studio, but actually play it live was amazing. It was so much fun. And every night, again, you know, because over the last 9 years or whatever, before we had done a new album, we were doing the same material over and over. We were still touring. We'd go to Europe and South America. We'd go to different places. But in America, here and there. But it's just, you know, to be able to go out and play new material was just the best ever. You know, breathe new life into everybody. Everyone was super happy. And again, it's a challenge. It's not the easiest stuff in the world to play, but it was a great time. I'm so happy that we did that. It's still my favorite songs to do live are the new ones. You know, it's just how it is.
Yeah, and you know, it's funny. I did get that impression, especially when I'm listening to the live album, because like when I go back and I listen to Theories of Flight, I mean, it sounds like everyone in the band just has this rejuvenated fire in the band. You know, just like the fact that you guys were able to get together after all this time to create some new music that was finally going on, and the fact that you guys were able to do so much great touring behind it, and now being able to have a live release which features those songs. I mean, it's so cool to see that.
Yeah, thank you, man. Thank you. Yeah, it's exactly how we feel. You know, so again, it was something like to give back to the people after all these years. And, you know, we say it almost every single night, you know, after all 30 plus years that you guys are still around. It's absolutely amazing. You know, I didn't see myself in 30 years ago doing this still. I don't know what I saw, but it wasn't this. So I'm still happy that we have fans, and I'm happy we're able to still do it and make music and go out and see the world.
And with that, I mean, obviously, with the title of the new live release being Live Over Europe, what was the decision to record shows throughout Europe to be able to have a full live release?
I'm not sure if I understand the question. I'm sorry.
I just mean, like, you know, with the album being live over Europe, what was the decision to record the European shows to get that a live release?
Well, I mean, honestly, if I want to be 100% honest, like, we have bigger audiences in Europe than we do in America. You know, we have some spots in America that we do really well in, but, you know, as a whole, Europe, as an American, I don't mean any insult, but I think Americans are really super happy to glom onto the next thing that comes along, whereas Europeans will stick with a band forever. I mean, there's bands here that have been around for 40 odd years, and they're still bigger. They're bigger now than they ever have been. You know, it's just kind of a culture here, how people stick with their bands, and so it was. You know, again, no offense to my American friends and America in general, but we're just appreciated here more, it seems. So it was kind of an easy decision to do it in Europe.
And that absolutely makes sense, and I've always noticed that as well. I mean, just like with the huge fan receptions that goes on in Europe or in South America as well, I always see, like, the love of metal that's going on down there. You know, it's just like, it's great to see, you know, yeah. Even from being an American yourself, you know, it's great to see that around the world you can see what other cultures, other countries, other continents are able to appreciate your music.
Yeah, I mean, like, for instance, if you go to, like, you know, America has festivals now, but a lot of them are fucking DJs. You know, you're really going to go to a concert to see a DJ live? Does that make sense to you? It doesn't make sense to me.
Not to me either.
But, you know, you have, like, these big festivals. I'm sorry?
Well, I was agreeing with you. It's like, when I go to a festival, I want to be able to see bands. I don't want to just see an Apple laptop.
And boy, it's the weirdest thing to me. But you have these giant festivals in America, and a lot of the main guests are deep. And you come to Europe, Germany, Italy, you know, even in Spain, all over Europe, Sweden, they have rock festivals, you know. Either it's a heavy metal festival or it's a rock festival, but it's bands. You know, it's all bands, and you just don't see that as much in America. And here, it's a festival. They have, like, a, you know, in all of Europe, it's like a festival season. You know, and people have to pick and choose which festival they want to go to. You know, and they're sold out right away. And these are, I'm talking 50,000, 80,000 people. You know, it's the music just seems, you know, again, and in most of these festivals, it's older bands, a lot of older bands that are playing, and people love seeing them. You know, it's such a cool thing. It really is. I like it. You know, and again, it seems like we're appreciated a bit more here. So it's kind of an obvious choice.
And with that, I mean, obviously, with the legendary festival circuit that does happen every year over in Europe, what is it like for you to be able to, like, adapt to the situations where either you play those festivals or the other parts of the year where you're doing headlining shows?
I mean, it's fun. I actually prefer, you know, theaters or clubs over big stages. I just like the sound better on stage. For me, it's much better to me. On, you know, on a big stage, the sound is all over the place, and you really don't have time to sound check. And I don't have the confidence that I do in a club setting or in a theater. You know, we sound check for about an hour, and we get our sound perfect. We know exactly what it's like. And when you do a festival, you have, you know, 10 minutes to get up and go, okay, that's cool, that's cool, that's cool. And then when everyone says 1, 2, 3, go, everything's fucked. Everything's completely different than what it was before, you know. And then you spend the first 15 minutes just trying to get the sound right. And that's just, we don't really get a big sound check, you know, so. But I mean, the crowds are cool. It's a lot of fun playing festivals. You get to see a lot of bands. That's like the best part about a festival, I think, is you get to, after you're done, you can go see whoever you want, you know, and you're there and you're part of the whole thing. And it's fun. It's definitely fun. I mean, I went to Hellfest with my wife a couple of years ago. First like festival I ever went to. It was 3 days, and we stayed in a hotel and went every day, and it was cool. You know, it's not my favorite thing in the world, but I appreciated it, and I love seeing all these people there every day. You know, just digging it. It's a big thing for a lot of people. You know, they wait all year for festival season to go to these rock festivals.
Oh, absolutely.
It's pretty
cool. Yeah. I mean, for my own personal taste, the closest thing I have to that here in America is Prague Power USA, being able to see these bands that I normally wouldn't get to see playing, doing these either like once-in-a-lifetime shows or just like once-every-few-years kind of shows. And, of course, you've been able to be a part of that with some amazing work over the course of Prague Power. But, you know, it's just like when you get into that European ideal, I mean, like Hellfest, for example, I mean, you're able to see so many different types of rock and metal that were going on at one time, and there is such a great acceptance over there as well too, and that's so cool to see that.
Totally. You gotta imagine a lot of the bands that are at the Prague Power thing are European bands too, you know what I mean? They've never stepped foot in American soil. That's kind of a cool thing usually, I think.
Oh, very much so. And you know, it's just, it's great to see that too. You know, it's just like, you know, like comparing this release here, the brand new Fates Warning live release, and you know, just like the fact that you guys are able to adapt to these situations. And you know, it's like sometimes you're playing with like black metal bands or death metal bands on these gigantic summer festival shows, or you're able to do these headlining shows.
That's always funny.
Yeah, and you know, it's just like over in Europe, I've always seen that more acceptance, where it's like they're able to appreciate so much different types of music out there.
Yeah, I agree. It's really cool. It's a really cool thing, actually. It's cool to be a part of it. Good to be invited back.
So, with that, I mean, obviously, with this coming live release, which is coming off, and showing Fates Warning in easily the top game that I've seen you guys in such a long time, what's going to be going on next for you guys?
Right now, I don't know. We're kind of in limbo. Everyone's kind of doing their own thing right now, which I'm sure things will be announced in the next few months. Everyone's kind of doing some stuff, and we have a tour we're working on, South America right now for October, and like different way down south, so we'll see if that pans out. It's 90%. We're waiting on the finals right now to see it happen. So we'll see. Everyone's busy working on something.
And with that, I mean, whether it can be announced or not, I'm not sure, but is there anything else that you're currently working on outside of Fates Warning?
Maybe. Maybe. I'm not at liberty at the moment to say, really, but I'm kind of working on something. I guess I could say that.
That makes me very excited. I mean, like, no matter the project that you've been a part of, I mean, I've always loved your vocal approach and the way that you approach things when it comes into every band. So, I mean, whether that would be something brand new, whether it's something from the past or collaboration, whatever that is, and we'll eventually get announced, I mean, that makes me very excited to see that there's going to be some new stuff coming from you.
Cool. Well, thank you. Well, maybe we'll talk again when the time comes.
Oh, yeah, I'd absolutely love that. And, you know, getting back into the live release here, I mean, you know, again, you know, it's just, it's great to see, like, over two discs being able to show off so much of what you've been a part of in the Fates Warning catalog and everything. When you do those live European shows and you're able to show off all the different eras of Fates Warning, what is the crowd reception that goes into it when you're doing it live? I mean, is it, like, the same that's going on there? Is there, like, a more reception to, like, the newer songs or the classic songs, or how does that go?
I mean, honestly, we're completely blown away that the new songs go over as well as the old ones. And I mean, myself being a musician of every different kind of genre out there, pretty much, you know, usually you go to a concert and you want everyone, you want the band to play the old stuff. You don't really care about the new stuff, especially a band that's been around for over 30 years. You don't, you know, like, it sucks to say, but most people just want to hear the old stuff, and they'll play the new stuff because they have to, and the band's really proud of it. But you know, maybe the fans aren't so into it. But for some reason, for us, you know, the last two albums we play, every song we play, people seem to like go nuts, and I think that's such a great sign. Again, we have some of the best fans in the world, and we like to think that they appreciate the fact that we're still around, I guess, you know. But the response for the new songs is just absolutely incredible. We could not have asked for a better response. It's just impossible.
Yeah, And again, as a fan, that just makes me so happy to hear that other fans are just as receptive to the new music as I am, because I love sounds like From the Rooftops just as much as I love something like Eye to Eye. I mean, just like the fact that you guys are in that position to be able to play songs like that, and it does get that overwhelming positive reception to it. I mean, when the next time I finally do get the chance to be able to check out the new songs live in From Fate's Warning, I mean, I'm just so excited to see how it's going to sound.
Thanks, man. Thank you very much. Yeah. Again, we were curious what it was going to sound like because we had no idea. The first time we played it live, it's like, oh, that's what it's supposed to sound like. Okay. Yeah, that's cool. I'm doing that. So, yeah, definitely cool.
Oh, very much so. And, you know, with that, I think that might be a good note to end on. And I, once again, appreciate you taking this time to be able to talk to me about everything that's going on with yourself. And, of course, talking about the brand new Fate's Warning release live over Europe, coming out at the end of the month for Inside Out Music. Being a longtime fan of yours, I mean, be it Redemption, be it Fate's Warning, be it Engine, you know, just like all of these different projects that you've been a part of, is an absolute honor to be able to talk to you. Wi-Fi connections permitting, of course,
please.
But just, you know, like when the new stuff, when you are finally able to start talking about, I'd love to be able to talk to you about whatever that is and get your insight into what's going on there. And it was just awesome to be able to talk about Fate's Warning.
Okay. Cool, man. Well, thank you. I really appreciate it. I very kind words. Thank you so much.